Good morning. So today, while I'd really like to get back to developing some Svelte and Go stuff, I've got one more itch with Snippet Pixie. Now that I doesn't look as though I'm going to be able to put it in the elementary app store as a flat pack, just because of flat pack restrictions. I need to make sure it's working really well as a snap. And one of the things that's different about a snap is the way it does its auto start config and stuff. It is kind of self-contained and stuff. So one of the issues there is on elementary. I look at the startup. This is on elementary 5 at the moment. It's my work computer. I'm not changing it just yet. You can see on the normal install, I have an entry for Snippet Pixie, which says I can. It's going to auto start yay and nay here. But on a snap-based system, I don't get that because it's all kind of self-contained, even though it is working. So, let's see if I can demo that. I think I've got a stable. Yeah. Let's do this. So, this is going to be a stable version of Elementary 6. And I think I've installed Snippet Pixie in here. We'll check. Yeah, so it's here. So without actually starting it up, I'll do a quick check of the system. It's already up and running. But if I go into the system settings, look at the startup, it's nowhere to be seen. And this is because Snap. It's in, I believe. If I just do just look for it here. I think it's in about snap, blah blah blah, but I'll just double check. Yeah. So it's in there, it's in. Snap, Snippet Pixie, current version. Config. Start. And that's the actual desktop file that does the starting. So that's good. So basically, once you have the snap installed, you can't control the auto start. There's no way to turn it off like you can in a native application version of Snippet Pixie. So I need to basically add something to the UI to allow you to stop and start Snippet Pixie. I think, but at the very least to say, do not auto start it, or do auto start it. So I think I've raised an issue for this. Yeah, I wrote this actually before I started testing the snap, because I had actually thought this would be a good idea even for existing native, because it's not entirely obvious that you need to go into the system settings to stop and start the auto start. So let's do this then. Got master there. Okay. What should I use for this? Should we try C line again? It doesn't have the syntax highlighting, but I haven't used it for a while. Plugs. Just check the plugins. Oh yes, gotta update that. Ooh, happy green. Okay. I need those at the moment. Okay. Just check develop. Make sure C-line is fully up to date with what Git is doing. Okay. That was from a while ago. New branch. What's the thing? 95. Shorten up a bit. Okay, all right. Clean up. Build. That's good. Okay. Here. Make sure we're running this conversion version, so get rid of that. Check the status. It's not running. Okay. So what I'm thinking, it's probably a setting right at the top here that just says auto start. This auto expand snippets. It's different. It could be considered as like, do we start? Should it be running in the background or not? But it doesn't work like that at the moment. If you want to use just the shortcut, once you use the shortcut, it's automatically running in the background. And for speed, that's a good thing. Because it's in memory then, and ready to go for the next time. So I think I'll leave it at that for the moment. And just do the whether it should start on login or not. And then turn it on and off, just to control that setting. So, yeah. Although, should there be a second setting? Keep running in background? Should it be keep running in background and start auto start and login being controlled by that? That would make more sense. Because then, even then, because at the moment, when I close this window, Snippet Pixie is still running in the background. It's not until you exit or yep. What's going on? What am I doing? Now it's gone. Yeah, maybe that's the idea. Maybe I should do the two settings. That could play nicely into some ideas I've had for the future, whereby I split the code out. Because at the moment everything's in the one binary. But it would be nice if we had a daemon, like a helper function, helper, that does basically the cool stuff. And then the UI is a separate process. Some people might not need the UI. Also, let's think here. So, I've also got auto start on off and status. Which in theory should tell me whether it's going to work or not. Good. Not running, but on here, status is running. And on, so good. Oh, that's good. So it recognizes that. Good. Right, okay, that's a good start. At least then we know the actual mechanism for doing that works. I wonder if, let's double check whether I can turn it off. Well, let's. Yeah, no. Auto start off, status off, should still be running. If I stop it, it's not running. Auto start status off. Still there, but the auto start enabled is false now, whereas it was true up there. Cool, okay, that's good. So in theory, I should not see Snippet Pixie come back up. It's there. Well, that's a bug. Definitely running. It's not some weirdness. Wonder what that is. I guess the auto start enables forces not being adhered to. That's probably a problem on different desktops as well. I wonder if that's a problem on like KDE and all that kind of stuff as well. Just with the normal binary as well. Okay, we might have to take a hammer to crack a nut here. We might just have to like remove the file. Yeah, okay. Right then. Think. Yeah. We'll have to change this. We'll have to make sure that if it doesn't exist, that we only create the file if a setting says we want to auto start. There's two ways we can handle that get as well. Could I could make sure it actually does do that and then just passes false. No, we don't need to do that. Okay. Right. First of all, we need the schema. If I can remember where that is, that's here somewhere. So we have settings in there, a bit of XML. This ordinarily gets installed. Let's put it here. Right, true. Auto start on login. If turned on, then Snippet Pixie will automatically start in the background. Desktop. Okay. That's one down, right? So I need to get the setting. So okay, so we need to do something like this. Is this the right place? No, that's a little bit late, I think. Oh no, should be right actually. I think we'll be all right. Okay, so if we're doing, all right, so Snippet Manager starts, checks the thingy, does the thing. Sets the settings. Just that once. Do the window thing. The app's already up and running. We don't need to go any further. Otherwise, we need to once only set up all the things. Okay, so we listen for any change to the auto start setting and update the global. Depending on that setting, and then we do a one-off setting of the global. Good stuff. Now we're going to have a clash here. Let's first do the get. So if we want it and it doesn't exist, then create it and return true. I think that's good. To start, actually, we're going to change this syntax, this, aren't we? I'm just going to remove it. Okay, I think we need to do something a bit different here. Let's take this. That. So that's a quick shortcut out to say, okay, if the file doesn't exist yet, but we want it to, do it. We want the alternate, we want the opposite as well, don't we? If not auto start. And not auto start exists. Let's put a comment there. Don't want auto start and it does not exist. We're done. Okay. I'll change this then a little bit. Where you want to start, but it does not exist. And that will cover in there, or it will complain if we can't create it and stuff, so we don't need to worry about that. If it works, it works. I want to start, but it doesn't exist to create it. Okay. I'm kind of changing the way, I mean, it's like get auto start. Okay, I've got my decision whether we go the brutal. If we do the brutal method here or not. I guess. Because some systems can override in settings, and the app has no control over that, I do need to manage the file there as well. If it works, it works. Yeah, okay. What we can do is yeah. So if at the moment the setting is do not auto start, but the file does exist. We're not going to remove it there or do anything. It's just, it is what it is. So we can come in here. Get that. Right, let's handle both cases where the file does not exist. So we have returned false if we didn't want to start anyway, and we've returned true if we did. So now we just need to handle the case where we do have a file. So, error. That's wrong. Get in auto start status. So that's fine. Okay. And now up here, ding, 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 ding. So I think here is where we're going to switch tax based on the state coming in. Right, okay, so it was creating it in theory. All right, here's the destination file. So let's do shortcut out for the negative case. So here, remove and cut it. Start while. Check and see where failures could happen before I set the setting as well, because it's updated. Okay, I think it's probably at the end of this block. expected. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to have to stitch things together a little bit here. It's time. Thanks. Oops. I'm out of time. Okay, I should be somewhere else. So, unfortunately, I've got to stop there and I'll have to finish this off tomorrow. So, until then, take care.